So we're conditioned to things coming in threes. Think about some of our most favorite stories, songs, and movies. Goldilocks and the Three Bears, the Three Amigos, the Three Little Pigs. I mean, you have once, twice, three times a lady. I surely did just sing for you. I did. Also, phrases, blood, sweat, and tears, stop, look, and listen. I mean, there's so many of these. And basically, our brains are just used to things coming in threes. We're conditioned to react and remember things that come in a three. So always remember this rule when you're making presentations. So let me show you how we can apply this rule of three to a presentation. First of all, this slide here, this was a slide full of maybe about eight bullets, and I cut it down into three main points here. So these are the three points that I think were the most important in this slide. And so what I did was I took this and then I even cut it down a little bit further and just took out the most pertinent information and just made these nice three little boxes, okay? Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and draw a rectangle. And I'm just going to draw it right over our text. And I'm just going to copy. I'm just hitting Option Shift to drag that over. And these are misaligned, but we'll fix that. Option Shift. A little trick here. When you have something that's too big, you can group them and then move them. That's a little trick. Okay, and then I'm going to send these to the back. So right now we have these nice little boxes. And what I'm going to do is just move this down. And we're just doing this super quick so I can show you. This stuff is bothering me, but I'll fix it real quick. So what we're going to do is just go ahead and grab a photo down here. We have some nice, lovely high-res photos that the client provided us. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and take this photo and resize. And just go ahead and make it the same width as the box. And then when I move this down, and I'm just doing this real quick, so I'm just going to copy the same picture just so you can see what it looks like with this format. But just like so, now you have a really clean format here, a really clean slide that looks way better than this, okay? So the same thing here. I had another slide that had a whole bunch of fluff. I cut it down. So I just did something like this where I just made it simple columns, just putting the information in columns, and you can animate those in, and it just looks way cleaner than this, right? All right, and my next most favorite, overused, but very effective technique is to use icons when I have the time. So what I do is I have my three areas, and I'll draw a circle or some kind of shape. And let's just go ahead and fill that with yellow. No stroke. There we go. And I'm just going to go ahead and create three circles. Now, I want to show you how quickly we can do this. Now, in PowerPoint now, you can do a really cool thing, and that is to just go ahead and go to Insert. And then you can go to icons. So let's say we're looking for, this first one is shifting employees. So you already see I have shift up there. And I think this graphic right here works pretty well. So I'm just going to click it and you see I have a check mark, but I'm not going to insert anything yet. The next one, team adjustment. So let's go to, let's just type adjust here and see what we can come up with. Okay. And we can use these sliders here. And I'll just check that. And the last one, less meetings, more time to work. Let's just type in meeting. And we can use this little chat bubble. So then once we insert those, you can move them to where they go. So I'm going to move this one here. I'm going to move the adjustments here. And I'm going to move less meetings. And then what I'm going to do is just make all of these white. Now, look at that. Very quickly, I just made a three icon format right in front of you using icons right from PowerPoint. Super, super easy. And last thing I want to show you is simply you can just use numbers. It works really well. It just shows an evolution here. We have first step. And again, you can animate this in, which is great. So you can show your first step here. You have an arrow, go to your second, and then go to your next one, three. Just use one, two, three. And it's a very, very elegant solution. All right. So the next time you create a presentation, remember the rule of three. It's going to get you out of trouble. It's going to focus your slides down, and it's just going to bring out the most important information and create a format that is going to be easily digested by your audience.